In this video, we demonstrate donning the equipment for suit support personnel. Suit support personnel are a vital part of a decon team. In addition to assisting with the donning and doffing of the team members' PPE, they also help with such tasks as taking vital signs and ensuring decon team members are properly hydrated. The suit support personnel will need the following equipment: water, a suit, outer boots, a respirator, chem tape or duct tape, goggles, inner gloves, and outer gloves. Be sure all jewelry and personal effects have been removed before beginning the donning process. Before donning the PPE, suit support personnel should drink at least 8 fluid ounces of water to help them remain hydrated while providing assistance. To begin the donning of the suit support equipment, carefully inspect the seams of the suit for tears or broken seals. You should select a suit that is at least one size larger than you would normally wear. This will allow for greater freedom of movement. Next, step into the suit and pull up to waist level. Once the suit is at waist level, apply the outer boots. The outer boots should then be taped along the upper rim, sealing the boot to the suit. Be sure to create a tab on the tape's end to aid in the doffing process. Next, apply the respirator per the manufacturer's directions. Make sure to seal check the respirator. Next, apply your eye protection. And then the inner gloves. Next, apply the upper portion of the suit, making sure the sleeves overlap the inner gloves. The outer gloves can then be applied. The outer gloves should be taped along the upper rim, sealing the gloves to the suit. Be sure to create a tab on the tape's end to aid in the doffing process. Next, seal the zipper flap of the suit with tape. Finally, the hood of the suit can be pulled over the head. Members of the decon team that are providing suit support will need to doff their own PPE without any additional help from other team members. PPE worn by decon team members providing suit support should be considerably less contaminated than other team members' suits, as they will have not been in direct contact with individuals going through the decontamination process. However, if you think that areas of the suit may have been chemically contaminated, you should clean those parts before starting the doffing process. The doffing process for suit support is as follows. Carefully remove all tape from the gloves and the boots and unzip the suit. Remove the outer gloves, being careful not to contaminate the inner gloves. Remove the suit only touching inner surfaces. Try and keep the outer surfaces turned in on themselves. Step into a clean area. Remove the inner gloves using glove and glove technique. Hands can be sanitized afterwards if desired. Respiratory protection should be removed last. Finally, wash your hands and proceed to a personal shower.